On the women's side, Nadia Comaneci came to town a determined young woman, 15 pounds lighter than a year ago, determined to win the all-around world title that has escaped her up to now. But a small mark on her hand grew into a dangerous infection. She gave it a try in the team competition, but had to retire after the balance beam. It would be wait till next year and the Olympics for Nadia. This development opens the door now for an appealing 22-year-old veteran from the Soviet Union, Nellie Kim. From Fort Worth, Texas, then, stand by for the men's and women's individual all-around competition in the 20th World Gymnastics Championships on ABC's Wide World of Sports. The eyes of scissor on the stars of the gymnastics world. Tarrant County Convention Center, Fort Worth, Texas. For the first time ever, the World Championships of Gymnastics are being held outside the European continent. And they've chosen to come to Fort Worth, 33 countries in all, more than 600 athletes. Good afternoon, I'm Jim McKay, welcoming you to these championships. The crowd, as you saw, is still filing in for the men's individual all-around competition, but it's been just about capacity crowds every night this week. A big hit here in Texas. You know, we first started going to these championships, really these international competitions in gymnastics, to see the famous Russians, the famous Japanese, and later on the Romanians. But now the Americans are very much a factor, very much competitive, as you'll be seeing particularly as the men's competition goes along. Let's bring in right now, however, a young lady who was the heroine in 1970 for the United States, the first time we ever covered a world championship in Ljubljana, Yugoslavia, Kathy Rigby Mason. Well, the ladies' competition is as close as ever, but it's a slightly different story with some negative aspects, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Because of some injuries in the competition, we have a few out. In fact, last year's world champion, Elena Mukina, will not be here because we understand she broke her leg. Also, during the compulsory competition, Nadia Comaneci sustained an injury to her wrist, I believe. So the number one position at this time is being held by Nellie Kim, and she has a good chance for the all-around at this time, leading this competition. She's hungry for that all-around because she's been overshadowed for so many years by Olga Korbut, Ludmila Tereshova, Elena Mukina, and of course Nadia Comaneci. This could be her time.
This time it looks like at long last the rest of the world will be seeing Nellie home, huh? Let's bring in now our expert on the May here in Fort Worth, Texas, and the 20th World Gymnastics Championships. Remember, it's the first time they've ever been held in America. In fact, it's the first time they've ever been held anywhere except on the European continent. The excitement here has been growing all week long. It's really been a fascinating place to be. I'm Jim McKay, and with me now is Kathy Rigby Mason, because we're about to move to the women's individual all-around competition. You know, Kathy, a lot of people seem to think that gymnastics is not really a physical sport, not a contact sport. And of course, there isn't any contact except with the equipment and with your own muscles, but there are a lot of injuries, a lot of illness situations, and we've seen a lot of that in the women's competition here.
That's exactly right. Well, last year's world champion, Ellen Mukina, could not make this trip because of a knee injury. Mm-hmm. Also, our own Rhonda Schwant would have been in this competition had she not had a knee injury. Also, Susie Kellums and also Marcia Fredericks from the United States, both plagued with ankle injuries. Mm-hmm. Also, our own Kathy Johnson, unfortunately, will not be able to compete tonight because of an illness, so there is a lot of it going around. And, of course, Nadia Comaneci is out because of a wrist injury.
Well, as in anything worthwhile, nobody ever said it would be easy. Nobody ever said it would be permanent, either. In the Munich Olympics of 1972, Olga Korbut was the newest name and the most explosive personality in international sport, a teenage gold medalist with a smile that charmed by satellite from Moscow to Miami. But 4 years later, this was Olga in Montreal. The strain of competition, constant travel, and a spotlight that never seemed to dim had obviously taken their toll on her. You grow up fast in international sport, but if you're pushed too hard, you grow old fast, too. The bright-eyed kid now looked like a little old lady. Sport crystallizes for us the inevitability of the passage of time. Nadia Comaneci of Romania had been an unheard-of 10-year-old when Olga made history in Munich. Now it was her turn for overnight world fame. She had given more advanced notice of her talent than Olga had. Still, no one was prepared for what she did in the Montreal Games. This performance was given a perfect mark of 10, the first ever awarded in Olympic competition. Having reached perfection, Nadia now became a phenomenon. In event after event, she scored 10 after 10. By the time the competition had ended, she had 7 perfect marks in all. Most experts think that we will never see such marks again. Olga had become the past. Nadia was the present. but the present becomes the past so quickly. By last year's World Championships in France, Nadia had matured in mind and body, but her 20 additional pounds slowed her down. There were no more tens. The cheers now sounded nostalgic. But Nadia's tough. Last spring in Tokyo, a slender-eyed, quick, thin Nadia appeared. She wasn't performing from memory this time, but with determination. This floor exercise belied the old maxim that they never come back, because Nadia, in the opinion of the judges, had returned to the stratosphere of perfection. They gave her a 10. It was just like the good old days of Montreal. And yet for her, Tokyo was to be but a way station on her way to Fort Worth. One thing had still escaped her, an individual all-around world championship. And so she arrived at these world championships even thinner than at Tokyo, 15 pounds under her weight of a year ago. Some thought she looked too thin, too drawn, but her performance on the opening day was dazzling. She took a big lead and looked like a shoe-in for the title. But sport, like life, deals in the unexpected. Nadia suddenly was taken to the hospital with a badly infected wrist. These are still pictures of her there. The doctor said the injury was a serious one. But the next day, she left the hospital, her face as unsmiling, as inscrutable as ever. It was announced that she would give it a try, and so she did. She competed in only one of four events, but helped her country to its first team title. The individual title was gone. Nadia had lost not to an opponent, but to a poisonous bit of life visible only under a microscope. Bacteria had accomplished what the other competitors had not. Now the girl who had heard deafening roars in Montreal heard a single child's voice call from the stands, "We still love you, Nadia." It was nostalgia time, all right, as it had been for Olga. You grow up fast in international sport, and sometimes you fade like an autumn flower at the first frost. But there are hardy perennials, too. Such a one is Nellie Kim. For years, she has performed in the shadow of Ludmila Tereshcheva and Olga and Nadia. She has had her tens and her titles, but always someone else with the star. Now time and circumstance have brought her moment. Ludmila and Olga are out of the sport. Nadia sits on the sidelines. It will be Nellie Kim, center stage, in the spotlight, all alone. Four events, the women's individual all around, as opposed to the six we saw in the men's. Here are the standings right now. Nellie, followed by Maxi Ganauk. The best American is Susie Kellens, who is 16. Here we go. Let's move now to Nellie Kim of the Soviet Union, the leader in this competition.
Let's see if Nellie will do her layout Sukihara. Very nice. She was long on that vault. Just a slight pike on the end. Not too bad. She could have used a little more height.
Trying for that first all-around world championship, an Olympic gold medalist. She had a 10 at Montreal, but still was in the shadow. Nadia Comaneci.
Nellie does a good vault here, but as I said, she needs a little bit more punch off that horse. She lays out her body for a long time and ends up having to pike because of a lack of rotation.
It's only the music that you're hearing there is for another competitor on the floor exercise, and there is the mark, 9.85. Good, solid mark for Nellie Kim. But if Nellie has become the present, the future is already on the way. Here now is Maxi Ganauk of East Germany. She's in second place right now. A performance of 9.95 here on the floor exercise could move her into a tie for the lead with Nellie Kim. That's a tough mark to get.
Jim,
but the East Germans think she's their best prospect in a long time. Yes, Kathy?
Jim, excuse me. This is one of the finest tumblers you'll see. Watch this opening run. A full twisting, double back salto.
Wow.
Beautiful. She never loses it. Endurance at all. Her dance could be improved on a little bit, but I tell you, I've never seen a stronger tumbler, and it doesn't look like she could tumble with those tiny little legs.
And this, I believe, is her best event, isn't it? Floor exercise.
Well, she's good on all four. She doesn't have any bad events. I would say the uneven bars are probably her best event, but like I said, she has no bad ones. Real up and comer for the East German team. Now she does, not only does she full twisting double back, she does a triple here. Watch this. Triple twist.
Wow.
One of the few in the meet, if not the only one.
That 9.95 might not be out of reach here.
Not at all. And for her last tumbling run, she'll do an even difficult vault again. She'll do a double back salto or a double back flip. Both names correct. Arabian. She does a double twist, changed her mind. Both runs exceptionally good.
The crowd sure was concentrating on that one. Little Maxi Ganauk of East Germany.
Let's see if you can count how many times she turns.
Okay, we're watching, and here comes the mark. 9.90, an excellent mark for Moxie Gunnell. She's not going to fold easily under the onslaught of Nellie Kim. We'll be right back with more. There is the leader in the women's individual all-around competition, Nellie Kim of the Soviet Union, but by a very narrow margin. Let's take a look at the standings. Nellie only by 25 one-thousandths over Moxie Gunnell, and then in the battle for third, Maria Filatova by 25 one-thousandths over Melita Rune of Romania. Now we move to the second of the four events in the women's individual all-around final, and this is Melita Rune of Romania. Remember, in fourth place, but by that extremely narrow margin. Rune from Romania.
Excuse me, one of the things they practice is landing that vault without stepping. Let's see if she can do it. That's a half on back, beautiful landing.
Melita Rune.
Great punch off that horse. One of the things we were talking about earlier, Jim, is run is so important. You have to build enough speed, as you'll see she does here. Enough speed, jam your body in a straight line into that horse, as you can see right here. She does a half on, another half with a front flip. Stretch those legs out, perfect landing. Well, almost a perfect landing, slight step there.
Here's her mark. 9.80. Now we're going to see one of the Americans. This is Susie Kellum. Susie doing very well here, but not the way they had hoped.
Jim, this is her first big championship, and she's done extremely well for the United States, working well here also.
17 years old from Westminster, California, tied for 22nd coming into this final phase.
She has great form, stretches every move to the fullest, right to the handstand. One of the things the judges are looking for. Little trouble there. I think she meant to make a stomach work, but she's continuing on. One of the things that's so important is to keep that routine going no matter what happens. Front with a oops. Didn't have quite enough rotation on that O-hide to get all the way around there. Looks like she... Excuse me, Jim. Looked like she had a little trouble on that one handstand and kind of lost momentum after that.
So three-point landing, and they prefer two. Now here is Maria Filatova. She's coming up next. Remember, she's in third place by a very small margin from Letha Rune. Just did extremely well. Susie Kellum's there waiting for her mark. Ooh, not so good. 9.00. But now here is Filatova. This is one of her best exercises, the three exercises or four exercises. This and the balance beam are the ones in which she's extremely good. And the reason I think Kathy agrees, is because of her tremendous grace and the beautiful way she uses not only her body, but her hands and even her facial expression. Watch Maria Filatova now. She needs a 9.8 to stay ahead of Melita Rune. Here comes the beauty.
Loves to get that facial expression, body movement in there.
Very much the Russian balletic influence here.
She plays to that crowd.
In a very different way than Olga Korbut did.
Exactly. You know, some gymnasts think that if you smile to an audience or you, hold your chest up and wave your arms around, that's being dramatic and that's being expressive in a routine. But she really shows in her facial expressions and body movements together exactly what's needed. Much like a prima ballerina.
And works with her music beautifully here. Very much like a great figure skater.
Yes. Jim, she's an excellent tumbler as well. This will be her second tumbling run. Whip over, flip-flop to a double twist.
And she presents it. She'll almost let you know what's coming, that this is important.
Yes, and this is where she takes a breather as well. I'm sorry, this is her last tumbling run, a double pike. Landed it fairly well, a little pike on the end. But look at this end. Is that not dramatic?
Okay. Maria Filatova. Is that a 9.8 or better by you?
Well, looks like it.
Well, we'll find out if she got that mark and held on to third place in a minute. The hands of Nellie Kim chalking up for her next event with that narrow lead over Moxie Gunnell. who is also yet to come. By the way, Filatova got a 9-8, holding on to third place over Melita Roon by that very narrow margin.
You know, Jim, Nelly's routine on the uneven bar, her style goes back a few years. She is not doing as many of the handstand moves or the high bar moves that some of the new upcoming gymnasts are, but she moves so well on this event from one bar to the other that the judges reward her for it, which is great. There's a straddle over the high bar, a move that's done a long time ago. It's not particularly, there's a one and a half twist, not particularly new. Free hip, heck, now watch this move. Brand new, heck, she jumps to the low bar.
Ooh.
Very nice. I think one thing that's important is that she surprises the crowd, which they react, and of course the judges react as well. There's a dismount front with a half twist.
Nelly Kim. Slow motion of Nelly.
There's a half twist on the bar. Gets as much height from her hips. Straddles over the bar. Good height with her hips as far as that straddle over is concerned. She goes right to a pike and her dismount. Feet stay on the bar as long as possible. Makes that half twist. Perfect landing.
And let's check the mark. Nelly ready to check it also. Looking for that world championship. There. 9-8-5. Whether the moves were new or old, the judges like them that well. Now we're going to move over to Maxi Ganao, the young woman who's in second place. She needs 9-9 to take the lead now.
You know, Jim, she has tremendous strength on the floor exercise, but she also does very well here. Good spring off. Layout, Sukahara. You see that she was laid out all the way around. One thing the judges want to see, they don't want to see any pike on the end.
Okay, stand by for her mark now. Maxi Ganao. 9.7. Ooh, not so good. That's going to cost her. And Nelly Kim knows that she's got a much solider lead now. Incidentally, Nadia Comaneci was returned to the hospital this afternoon and operated on. Remember, she has that infected hand. That's why she's not in this competition on this occasion. Dr. Bailey Cothran is the medical director of the World Gymnastic Championships here in Fort Worth. Was one of the, well, I guess you were the first medical person to see Nadia Comaneci's injury early in the week. Can you tell me exactly what you saw?
At that time, she had a very small, 1/8 in diameter ulceration, surrounded by a redness about the size of the old silver dollar.
Yeah.
And raised about, I'd say, a half inch. There was a streak of redness, a line moving up the arm.
That's not a good sign, is it?
No, sir. That's not a good sign. And a very tender node, lymph node, just above the elbow, which we call an epitrochlear node.
Could you tell what it might be from?
Well, this was obviously infection. Bacterial invasion of the area causing cellulitis of the skin and then involvement of the lymphatics and the lymph nodes.
But it's nothing that can't be cured.
No, sir. It can be cured.
All right. The competition will continue here in a minute. Third mission has been completed now, and the standing of the leaders is unchanged. Maxi Ganao gained a bit, but not enough on Nelly Kim. Now we move to the final round, where Maxi will make her final effort to catch Nelly Kim. Now, she has to go on the balance beam before Kim does her floor exercise.
That's a front aerial mount. You know, it's really tough when you're under as much pressure as she is now. To have to compete on the balance beam, it seems to be the most nerve-wracking event of all. She's a tough competitor, getting ready now for aerial, or back gainer on the beam. Oh, big break, at least 3/10 of a point there. Maybe the judges will take into consideration the difficulty of that gainer. She looks like she's looking a little bit off to the side, which is, she looks like she's distracted just a little bit there. Handspring. She's working a little stiff right now.
Remember, the 2/10 of a point could make all the difference here.
I don't think she's going to catch up with her at this point. And of course, Nelly's competing in her strongest event, the floor exercise. No-handed forward roll.
Oop, a little mistake there too.
Those little bobbles really do make the difference.
cost half a tenth a point. Sometimes they cost a little bit more, one or two tenths.
Maxie Gnauk certainly will be a factor in the Olympic Games in Moscow and in future world championships.
No doubt about that. Getting ready for a big move, an aerial. Ah, her dismount, double twist.
Okay.
Good landing, but a few breaks in there, Jim.
She's made her final effort then. And a good effort it's been all the way through these days of competition leading towards the women's individual all-around championship. All right, now let's move across to the floor exercise. Nellie Kim coming out, hoping to clinch her first world championship. Remember, she's 22. And as we said, she's been in the shadow of the great Ludmila Tereshcheva, the shadow of Olga Korbut, of Nadia Comaneci, although all through these years, she's been one of the world's great gymnasts. Not only won a gold medal at Montreal, but got a perfect mark of 10. You can't do better than that. But Nadia was there, too. The mark for Gnauk, 9.70. So even a 9.55 would win the championship here for Nellie, and she's capable of much better than that.
Oh, very capable. She starts out with a double pike. She's also very capable of doing a full twisting double back, but I doubt she'll do it. I'm sure she'll keep the routine clean and not take any extra risk.
And again, something new in gymnastics, full orchestration for accompaniment.
Done very easily, a double pike. Jim, just wait till it goes into a kind of a disco music.
I think it already is.
She looks very relaxed out here now. Relaxed yet tight enough. Beautiful opening. That was a pike, only she opened up while she was still upside down, which makes kind of a nice style there. I think I've heard this in a few discos.
Yeah. What an attractive figure she is out there, though.
She certainly is. Really great maturity. She's never looked better than she does now.
And there's a warmth to Nellie Kim. She communicates to the audience.
Well, even when she's not on camera, even when she's not out there competing, she's nice to everyone. Ended with a full twist and back. She's not putting all her difficulty in. But you can bet that Kradlin will like this routine.
Well, almost certainly they're saluting the new women's individual all-around world champion, Nellie Kim. There's Polina Ostapkova, her coach, lifting her up. She was known as the Russian Birch when she was a champion at Rome in the Olympics in 1960. 9.85. That does it. Nellie Kim is the world champion. She's finally done it at age 22 after long years of international competition. Yet to be determined, however, is the bronze medal. We'll be back for that.
Hello, Edward.
Now at the uneven parallel bars, Maria Filatova of the Soviet Union. She's good at this one, and she'll have to be tonight, remember, if she wants to win the bronze medal for herself.
And this mount, front salt over the high bar, she really has to take a hard run for that. Watch this, she goes into giant swings. Now watch, she'll make a half twist here. After this, she switches her hands around, and a front somi. Beautiful. Whoops, not quite an... Oops,
there could be the slip that could cost her the bronze medal.
Interestingly enough, Jim, that kip that she did on that low bar is a basic move, but she just didn't seem to have enough speed.
Well, she's only been leading Melita Rune of Romania by 25 one-thousandths of a point, and here comes Rune on the balance beam. Let's move over there now. Melita Rune has her opportunity. We don't have the mark yet, of course, for Filatova.
You know,
that'll be coming up.
You know, it's a good thing that Melita didn't see that fall on the bars. I think it would break her concentration having to go up right away, right after Maria.
Actually, she was facing in that direction. I was watching her. I think she probably did see it.
Hopefully her concentration was good. Beautiful. She's solid as a rock there.
Here's the mark for Filatova, 9.40. So all Rune needs is 9.45 to take that bronze medal.
You know, she is aware of what happened on the uneven bar. She may take some moves out. She may take some of those skills, extra wrist moves out. Front flip. Nope, she sure didn't. She's hanging in there with the same routine, going for it all the way. Once again, those head, shoulders, hips, legs all have to be in line with that balance beam, directly over it. Looks like she's getting ready for the dismount now. Although she shouldn't quite pause as long as she is. Here it is, round off, double back.
Okay.
She could do it.
In fact, there really shouldn't be much doubt about that. By the way, that music, once again, was not for the balance beam, but for somebody else on the floor exercise. They're very sure of it in the Romanian delegation there. There it is, 9.8. No question about it, Melita Roon has come from behind to win a bronze medal in these world championships. And still, things are not quite over. Here is the current world champion on the uneven parallel bars, Marcia Frederick of the United States. That's in the individual events, remember. And we'll be seeing her in the individual event final at a later date on ABC's Wide World of Sports. She's out of the competition, real as far as the individual all-around is concerned here, way down in tie for 35th place. But on the unevens, there's nobody like her when she's hot.
She makes it look so easy, which is the most important thing. Stalter beats the low bar. Another 1.5 twist.
Oh. Whoa. And a fall. Concentration gone now.
Right, just not enough motivation in this competition to really go for it, it seems.
It has not been a great meet for the American women. She'll finish it out now.
I don't think she was really prepared mentally, having to go in at the last minute as she did. But you can see the precision in those handstands. Whoops. Looks like a little bit of giving up there.
No matter how many thousands of times you've done that routine, if the concentration isn't there,
right.
It doesn't happen.
Just not enough aggression, it seems, or aggressiveness put into it.
Well, it kind of unfortunately typifies the sort of luck and performances the American women have had here this week. Now, here come the official final standings. The winner and the gold medalist, Nellie Kim of the Soviet Union, then Mexican Alk of East Germany, Melita Roon, and Maria Filatova. In a minute, we're going to meet the American men who gave such a great account of themselves in these championships. For official in the women's competition, let's meet the medalists. Here they are, from left to right, gold, silver, and bronze.
Ladies and gentlemen, the individual all-around champion of the world from the Soviet Union with 78.65 points, Nellie Kim.
It took her a long time, but Nellie Kim has finally made it. She is women's individual all-around champion. As for the Americans, Leslie Piper finished 12th. That was her best finish. Susie Kellums was 19th. Marcia Frederick, 23rd. Kathy Johnson had the best record of any American coming to the finals. However, shortly before this competition began, she was taken ill and was to compete. She was placed 37th. But Nellie Kim is the winner, the gold medalist, the champion. This is going to be a day of firsts here at these World Gymnastics Championships, and here's one right now, something that's never happened before in the sport. An American woman defending her world championship. Marcia Frederick, yes, is the current world champion on the uneven parallel bars. At the moment, she's in seventh place here in trouble, but still only 0.125 out of the lead. So a super performance could still do something for her.
She's certainly capable of that, but I've seen the biggest improvement on the uneven bars as a whole by all the gymnasts in the past year, and it's going to be tough. But if anybody can do it, Marcia's the one. Full twisting stalter, beautiful. 1.5 twist. She's working very easily. Very smooth. She keep up the good work here. Right to a handstand. There's a toe on, half twist. Front with a nice exercise. Should receive a high mark.
Fine exercise by Marcia Frederick, the pride of New England in the gymnastics world.
She's had an injury to her ankle, but that shouldn't affect her on the uneven bar. She's been able to work this more than any other event. Let's take a look at that dismount. Here's her handstand. She goes to what is called a toe on, right up to another handstand.
9.8. You think it was better than that?
Well, this dismount is not her regular dismount. It doesn't show quite the difficulty that she, as a matter of fact, she had in Strasbourg. So I think the score is pretty fair.
I have a feeling that there will be no medal this year for the defending gold medalist, Marcia Frederick. There could be a medal and a big one for this young lady, however, Yahong Ma from the People's Republic of China, because she's tied for the lead coming to the final here. Now, I mentioned earlier, I think, that the People's Republic of China athletes have been among the most popular here. Some people thought that the marks they got in the individual all-around could have been higher, and in the team competition, too.
She could do it here. She has a 9.925 average, I believe.
That's right.
You'll see why in a minute. starts out with a half twist kip to the high bar. Impeccable form. You'll never see her legs break. Look at that toe point. Watch this. Free hip right to the handstand. Full twist.
Wow.
You can see why she's receiving such high marks. I think she has the best toe point in the competition. There's another free hip, our clear hip as we call it, to a Stalter. Tremendous flexibility. Okay, watch this dismount.
Ma of the People's Republic of China. Remember, Kathy, I was over there a couple of years ago. When I came back, I think I told you, I was so impressed with the way their whole program had changed. Remember some years ago, they used to have big and heavier girls?
It certainly has changed. Look at the obvious control she shows on this exercise, especially on this dismount. Let's watch.
And there's the mark, 990. She's the leader now. Remember, she was tied for the lead coming into this phase with Maxi Ganalk of East Germany.
And here is Maxi, needing a 9-9 to tie for the gold medal, 9-9-5, apparently to win it. There are others yet to come, remember, but in relation to the other girl with whom she was tied for the lead.
It seems thin as in with this gymnast, but when you're carrying any extra weight around, it's almost impossible to do some of these handstand moves. There's a vault over the high bar. Need a tremendous amount of strength in the entire body just to pull that off. There goes another free hip. Jim, she's having no problems. Front with a half twist.
Okay.
She just might beat Ma.
Pretty tough to score those two against each other.
One slight advantage she has over Ma is that she works with a little straighter body, not quite so much arch, and that's something that is important when working the unevens. Here's that front with a half twist, good height. And absolutely no steps on the landing.
9-9-0. So we have a tie for the lead now between Maxi Ganalk and Yanun's Ma, China. And now Amelia Everly of Romania. She'd need a perfect mark of 10 to move into the lead. And a 9-9-5 would not tie her for the lead either. So perfection is what she's after. And I guess she's always after that.
That's exactly right. I don't think Bella lets them get away with anything less. Stalter. They go through at least 10 bar routines every time they go in the gym. There's a vault over the high bar. Good power in that entire body to get over that high bar like that. Handstand. There's what we call a Christ carry, named after the man who invented it. Judges are looking for those gymnasts to go right to the handstand on those free hips and those stalters.
Okay. Looking for a medal there is Amelia Everly.
It's not so much that it's difficult, it's more spectacular for an audience to see. Very pleasing to the eye. She just wraps that low bar, drops one arm, and makes a half twist. Sounds easy. Looks not too complicated when you can see it in slow motion.
9-9. Real good solid mark.
And here you can see her pike on, and she does a dismount her teammate Nadia Komenich made famous. Komenich dismount.
And there is little Amelia awaiting, as we are, the official results in this event. We'll be right back.
As greatest first of China, Ma Young.
The results are in on the uneven parallel bars, and we have a tie for the gold medal between Yanghong Ma here from the People's Republic of China. That country making an impressive return. They haven't been in the World Championship since the early 60s. And here a tie for the gold medal, tied with young woman from East Germany, Maxi Ganalk.
In addition, from the German Democratic Republic, Maxi
Ganalk. Girls from opposite sides of the world tying for the gold medal. Incidentally, the days when one country dominated women's gymnastics seem to be gone now, and for a long time to come. First, it was the Russians who dominated, then the Romanians, but now here you see People's Republic of China, East Germany, and finally a Romanian in third place. You'll be seeing in a moment here Amelia Everly winning the bronze medal on the uneven parallel bars. As for the defending world champion, who was from the United States of America, remember, Marcia Frederick, she finished sixth this time. So that's the story on the uneven parallel bars. There is, of course, much more to come here. And we'll be back for that. But now to Howard Cosell for the continuation of our coverage of the legendary Pool Players show.
Last week, we began...
Again at the Tarrant County Convention Center in Fort Worth at the individual events finals of the women's competition in the World Gymnastics Championships. This is Jim McKay with Kathy Rigby Mason, and here is Nellie Kim, the women's all-around champion, but these are for gold medals on the individual events, remember, and this is the balance beam, always beautiful and dangerous.
Press handstand mount. Nellie is usually very tight on the balance beam, very secure.
She also in a tie for second place with Filatova and Groboli.
One thing you try to do when you're up here is think of it, each move as it comes, concentrate on not worrying about difficult moves coming up, because sometimes you make all the hard tricks, our skills, and you miss the easy things. Solid as a rock there. Two back saltos or back flips, whatever you want to call them, in a row. Nellie covered up a little error just a second ago, but the judges won't take off anything because she was able to ad lib. Here's her Valdez. Not a difficult move, but goes with the continuity of the routine. Right into a gainer back handspring and another gainer back handspring. You see there, she was off a little bit to the left and she just made the pose a little different. One thing you get from years and years of competition. Gainer back flip off the beam. Another solid exercise.
Nellie Kim trying for yet another medal to add to her large collection.
You know, Nellie makes these two back salters or back flips look so easy, and that's because she's very strong in her legs, and after doing 50 backflips a day, maybe 3 to 6 months.
And look how perfectly positioned she is once again over that 4-inch beam.
Let's take another look at that gainer dismount. The one thing you want to do on this dismount is to get far enough away from that balance beam so your toes don't hit. There she is. Little pose. You see, they do a little bit of her dance routine first. You've got to reach way out in front of you. Clear those feet. Pretty landing.
And there's Nellie awaiting the judge's decision, and there it is. 9.85. That's a good, solid competitive mark. Remember, she's in a tough battle here. She was in a triple tie for second coming in. So, included in the triple tie for second place in this event is Regina Groboli of East Germany.
Teammate of Maxie Ganauk, and she certainly doesn't take a back seat to Maxie. She's just as talented. Starts with an aerial front. The one problem she does have on the balance beam is she tends to work a little loose in her back. And sometimes she bobbles. Back flip. That was a gainer back flip, as solid as a rock so far. Working well on her toes, one of the things the judges watch for. That was called a no-handed forward roll, obviously.
Yes.
And she's getting ready to do a back handspring right into a back layout. You know, all the gymnasts are working with much more freedom than they were the first few days of competition here. Right into a front flip.
Yes, this is the climax of the meet, but they do know that there's no more work tomorrow.
That's right. Get to rest. Here's her two back, one back flip, our salto, back handspring. She's having no problem so far. Except on that little dance step, she had a little slight break there, not much. Very nice leap. They should get 180 degrees in the air. Complete split. Looked like she looked a little off to the side. Sometimes that can be very critical. She goes for a dismount, round off, and either a double twist or just a full twist. Let's see what she does. Both feet on the beam, double twist.
Regina Groboli. Well, the be getting her mark in a minute, and then we'll be seeing the leader in this competition, one of the tiniest of them all, Vera Cherna of Czechoslovakia.
Cherna prepares to begin. We have the mark for Regina Grabowski, 980, not good enough to move ahead of Kim. Here's the leader in the competition. Trying to go for that gold medal right now, little Vera Cherna of Czechoslovakia. Mark of 975, a win for her.
Jim, as we've seen in the past, very unpredictable. She could, if she hits, obviously she can win that gold medal. Oh, beautiful press. It's called a planche. But sometimes she has a tendency to be wobbling. Good leap.
One of the smallest of this world assemblage of little ladies.
And that's small in gymnastics.
About 4'8".
Really concentrating. Most concentration I've seen from her on this piece of apparatus. Good split leap, complete split in the air.
Well, there's a gold waiting at the end of that beam if she can make it.
She looks very aggressive, which is important. Slight break there. She's not going to let anyone or anything take that gold away from her. All she has to do is keep tight now. Watch this. Look how flexible she is.
Oh, look at that. That hurt my back.
But that's really a critical move, because if you're just slightly off, if your balance isn't directly in the center of your body, you're off. There you go. Two solid back flips. You can see she barely moves her upper body, and that's so that she doesn't throw anything off. Just leaps in the air. I think she has it. So back handspring, layout, dismount.
You're right, I think she's got it. Vera Cherna.
Let's take a look at those two back flips. You can see that her shoulders go directly up. She tries to rotate her hips and her legs over her shoulders. You can see on most of her moves that even though her arms and her head and her legs move, the center line of her upper body always remains directly over that balance beam. Right here, you can see it. There's another leap. Complete control. So important on this event. Getting ready for a dismount.
We've talked often in the past about the danger and difficulty of the balance beam and about the long hours of practice and dedication that these youngsters put into it. There's Vera Cherna, by the way. Here's a mark, 990. That's good enough. So this time we thought we'd have Kathy Rigby Mason do a little demonstration on the balance beam with Tracy Talavera so you understand a little bit more about it.
After watching a world-class or an
the balance beam. And now the official results. Vera Cherna is in fact the winner. Little Czechoslovakian, a worthy successor to another Czechoslovakian Vera we remember. Vera Czaslavska, multiple gold medalist at Mexico City in the Olympics 12 years ago. So Vera Cherna gets the gold. Nellie Kim had to settle for the silver medal this time, and Regina Grabowski was third. We'll be right back. We're back again in Fort Worth at the World Gymnastics Championships, and let's have a look at the winner in the vault competition, which took place earlier. This was Dumitrita Turner of Romania, another of that bottomless Romanian team, it seems. They just go on and on and keep appearing. She's a relatively new competitor, but now a world champion. If that looks easy to you, take a look at what happened to Susie Kellams of the United States. It's been a tough meet for the Americans, and so it was on this vault. Looks pretty good up to here, but down and out was Susie. Not only the Americans, though, this was Zheng Zhu of the People's Republic of China, looking very good, really, on the uneven parallel bars, up to a point. Very well balanced through here. Everything looks okay, but wait until her dismount right here. Just too short on her feet, but then ignominiously on her head. Take a look at one of the best in the world, Maria Filatova of the Soviet Union. Again on the uneven bars, she's just beginning her mount. Takes one swing, grabs for the bar, it isn't there, and she went straight on through. So it's a very difficult sport, gymnastics. Usually we see only the perfection of the medalists. Here's the way it ended up in the vault. It was Turner the winner, followed by Zakharova, Nellie Kim, Krista Kanary of the United States was fifth, and Susie Kellams was eighth.
And there is Nellie Kim warming up for the final event on the program. That'll be the free exercises, and we'll be back for that. But now let's return to the legendary Pool Players Showdown with Howard Cosell. The Tarrant County Convention Center in Fort Worth, Texas. This is the World Championships of Gymnastics. Jim McKay here with Kathy Rigby Mason as we move to the free exercises.
The first performer we'll see here is Maria Filatova of the Soviet Union. She is the co-leader coming to the final round, along with Emilia Eberle of Romania. The Russians yet to win a medal in these individual event finals, to win a gold medal, I should say.
Well, this is her favorite event. She starts out with a double pike front loop. Really is going to have to carry that around. Steps out.
Nope, that'll cost.
That's going to cost about a tenth of a point. Chip, she really looks like she enjoys this event.
She does.
So dramatic. And she's really pouring it on tonight. Last event for her. As I said earlier in a broadcast before this, they're using orchestration.
The first time, that's right, is
exactly.
International competition.
Yes. Have a lot of endurance now to throw this last tumbling run. That's why she's resting in the corner there. Round off, flip-flop, double pike. Ooh, she really had to pull those legs around. What an ending.
Maria Filatova trying to bring the Soviet Union its first gold medal of these individual event finals in the first three events. Because of a tie, there have actually been four gold medals. They've gone to four different countries: Romania, China, East Germany, and Czechoslovakia.
Maria doesn't get quite as much height as some of the gymnasts on this double pike salto or double back. A little flat on this front to begin with. Needs a great deal of speed to get enough punch to go up. She's a little off on that back handspring. You can see her legs are slightly off. So she has to really hold on to this pike, and she overspun it, which made her fall back.
Step out of bounds.
You're right.
And that step out of bounds could have cost her. There's the mark, 980. Could have been a tenth of a point.
Next competitor from the Soviet Union.
Well, here she is again. She's in everything. Nellie Kim, the current women's world all-around champion. Tied for third here, but she's only 25 one-thousandths of a point out of the lead coming to the final phase. She could easily win, particularly now with her teammate Filatova having not had an impressive performance.
And I think most people figure this is their favorite event to watch Nellie, and she just seems to bring the audience to her warm personality. You can really hear the difference with this music, the orchestration on Nellie's routine. Starts out with a double pike. Or better, a full twisting. No, a double pike. A little step afterwards, but she certainly didn't step out of bounds.
Can't afford many mistakes. She needs a 9-9 to take the lead here.
Unlike some of the gymnasts, Nellie gets a lot of height on her tumbling. Does it with a lot of ease. Pike open? Certainly not that difficult at this level of competition, but she does it clean. There should be no deduction.
What do you think the gymnasts of ancient Greece would think if they suddenly woke up and saw this performance with this music? It's changed a bit, hasn't it?
Oh, it certainly has. It used to be very stiff and stoic, and now they're adding so much personality. And with the disco music, it really adds a new dimension. Down up the button. Double back! There's that extra wrist.
Okay. Well, her teammate failed in trying to bring that one gold medal to the Soviet Union. And
this competition here today, but boy, she doesn't have the look of someone who's failed. Lisa 9-9, remember? Ashtakova there, the blonde woman, the coach with a great star in Rome in 1960. And here is the star of these world championships, Nellie Kim.
Jim, they're giving her a standing ovation.
Daughter of a, there it is, 9-9-5. Is that good enough? You bet.
Results for Nellie
Daughter
Kim,
of a North
nine,
Korean father
five,
and
nine,
a mother
five.
Of Tartar extraction. 9-9-5. That'll give him something to shoot at.
Well, the only thing the judges could take off her was that slight over-rotation on this double pike at the beginning of her exercise. She was so high, she just held on a little too long.
Here is Melita Rune. She also was tied for third coming to the final phase. She would need a mark of 9.95 to tie. She'd need a mark of 10. A perfect mark to win all by herself.
That might be difficult to do, but she opens up with a double pike. She has very powerful legs for tumbling. No problem on that move.
We said we haven't seen a 10 since Montreal Olympics. They seem to have given them all out on that occasion.
You know, since Strasbourg, last world championships, the Romanians seem to have put together routines that are especially pleasing to the audience. Her second tumbling run, she started off with an Arabian. It is right there, a 1.5 twist. She changed it to a back tuck. I think they were criticized, Jim, a little bit for giving too many tens in the world championship. They left no room to go anywhere.
We haven't seen any in world championships since then.
Not to say that the routines haven't improved a great deal. Little rest here before her last tumbling run.
I frankly think the orchestrations have added a lot to the pre-exercise. I'm sure there's going to be a lot of difference of opinion about that.
Well, I think a lot of people were skeptical at first, but like I said, it really fills the arena with both the gymnast and the music. Very well executed. Double salto this minute.
All right. Was it or was it not a 9.95? That's the question. That would tie her for first place at the moment with Nellie Kim. Seem to like it just about as much as they like Nellie. Nellie Kim. Not quite. So Nellie Kim still leads. However, remember, Everly, who was tied for the lead coming into this round, is yet to come. Leslie Piper of the United States is in sixth position.
The American women have not had the best competition here. However, they have placed a gymnast on every event almost in the finals, and that's progress. Three out of the four events.
A few years ago, when you were the only one to make the finals, that was a major event in itself.
Well, when Linda Matheny first made the finals in 1968, we celebrated all night.
Yep. By Leslie Piper. Trying to move up a bit from sixth position.
bit shy. Not... There she goes. Well-deserved applause.
9.75. Here now, the last performer in these world championships, Emilia Everly of Romania. And the last performer still has a chance. In fact, tied for the lead coming to the final round here. Can she beat out Nellie Kim? Well, a 9.95 would do it.
Jim, she has an interesting routine for being such a somber lady, or seemingly so, never smiling. She shows more animation in this exercise than anywhere else. Sometimes frustration and sometimes joy. Runs in the competition. 1.5 twist to a flip-flop, full twist. Or tuck. Watch this.
Very nice.
Frustration.
Romanians tend to like to put some playful action into these floor exercises, it seems.
I understand some of it is their, some of their dances that they do in their country, some of their folk dances. And our last tumbling run, a double twist, a double back.
What's that? 9.95 is not out of the realm.
Not at all.
Millie Everly, last performer in the World Championship for Women. Headed down the steps now towards her teammates. Kind of interesting that with Nadia Comăneci reach out with an injury, the Romanians seem to have rallied around as a team a little bit more. A little bit more smiling among them. Pats on the back last year at the World Championships in Strasbourg, France. They were quite glum and silent the entire time. Not so here today, as you can see. A little extra bow for Emilia Everly. Should be a good mark. She did it, 9.95. The gold medal goes not to the Soviet Union. They are shut out for the first time that I can remember, certainly in a long, long while. No gold medal for the Soviet Union. There'll be two for Romania here, one for China, one for East Germany, and one for Czechoslovakia. Five gold medals in the four events. Nellie Kim there gave it the big effort, the good try, but didn't quite make it. She'll settle for the silver. Third place to Melita Roon, the